Hello friends, welcome to the Viva Voice of Anatomy. Today we will discuss the duodenum and the pancreas. Now in the exam these two organs are given together, but here we will see it separately one by one. First we see discuss about the duodenum and then about pancreas. So we start with the duodenum. In the Greek language the duodenum means dodecadactylos. Its meaning, it is 12 finger long. Now the duodenum is a retroperitoneum, the fixed and the most dilated proximal part of a small intestine. It is a starting of the small intestine and it is dilated. Duodenum start from the pylorus of the stomach proximally up to duodeno-jejunal flexor distally. Now the duodenum is C-shaped. You can see it is a C-shape, and within the concavity of the C lies this head of pancreas. Extension, the duodenum lies at the level of opposite L1, L2, L3 vertebra above the level of umbilicus. Now we see the parts of the duodenum. Before that, the total length of the duodenum is 25 cm long, or you can say 10 inch long. Now it is having four parts: the first part, second part, the third part and the fourth part. The first part is 5 cm long. It is called a superior or upper part, extending from the pylorus of the stomach toward the right side up to the superior duodenal flexor. Now, the first part is the most dilated part of a duodenum. It devoids of circular mucosal fold and it is a common site for a peptic ulcer after stomach. Now, second thing, the first part is supplied by an artery which is a supraduodenal branch of gastroduodenal artery, which is known as an artery of Wilkie. Now, the important of the first part is that it is devoid of circular mucosal fold, that you can able to see from second part onwards. It devoids of the circular mucosal part. Because of that, in the radiograph taken after the barium bill, the first part is known as a cap, which is known as a duodenal cap. Second reason of a producing duodenal cap is the first is a absent of the circular mucosal fold. Second is the first part is protruding into the pylorus of the stomach. So this is the important of the first part. Now the second part of the duodenum, which is known as a vertical part, start from the superior duodenal flexor up to the inferior duodenal flexor opposite the L1, L2, L3 vertebrae. The most of the part of the second part is a retroperitoneum and fixed. Now important lies in its interior. I had already opened the second part of the duodenum to see its interior. Here you can see the thick mucosal fold, thick circular mucosal fold, and this is permanently set. This thick circular mucosal fold is known as a plica circularis. Now the second, there is a small conical elevation of a mucous membrane which is known as a major duodenal papilla. Here this one, the small conical projection of a mucous membrane which is known as a major duodenal papilla. On the summit of it you can see the one dark structure, that is a opening of hepaticopancreatic duct. Okay, so in the major duodenal papilla opens the hepaticopancreatic duct, and this opening or a major duodenal papilla lies approximately 8 to 10 cm distal to the pylorus. Now, above the major duodenal papilla, you can see the arch mucous membrane, arch fold of a mucous membrane, which is known as a plica semicircularis. Okay, now here from the major duodenal papilla, here the fold of the mucous membrane going vertically, extend vertically downwards, which is known as a plica longitudinalis, right? So there are three types of the mucous membrane or a mucosa. This is plica circularis, plica semicircularis, plica longitudinalis. Now about 2 cm above the major duodenal papilla, there is a small opening or a small elevation of mucous membrane, which is known as a minor duodenal papilla. Here you can see the dark point structure. Here it shows the opening of a accessory pancreatic duct. This is a minor duodenal papilla, lies 6 cm distal to the pylorus. Okay, so this is about the interior of a second part of. Now the third part of the duodenum, it is 10 cm long. It extends from the inferior duodenal flexure up to the fourth part, which lies in front of the aorta. This part is known as a horizontal part. Now the last part, that is a fourth part of a duodenum, and it is a 2.5 cm long. It extends in front of a aorta up to the duodeno-jejunal flexure. Here you can see the angle which is formed between the duodenum and the jejunum, which is known as a duodeno-jejunal flexure. Now one important ligament is attached at a posterior surface to this duodeno-jejunal flexure, which is known as a suspensory ligament of duodenum or a ligament of Treitz. Superiorly, it passes behind the pancreas and attached to the right crust of a diaphragm. This ligament suspends this duodeno-jejunal flexure in its position, and when it contracts, it increases the angle of a duodeno-jejunal flexure, which allows the easy process of passage of the food from the duodenum into the jejunum. And the component of this ligament is its proximal superior part is made up of a striated muscle. The middle part is made up of an elastic fiber, and the lower part is made up of a non-striated fibers. So this is about gross anatomy of a duodenum. Now the last thing about the ligament of Treitz, it is a remnant of a superior retention band of a developing gut. Now we see the last part in the duodenum, its blood supply. Now the duodenum is partly supplied from developed from the foregut and partly from the mid gut. Now the area of the junction, this junction of the foregut and the mid gut, lies at the level of the major duodenal papilla. So the part of the duodenum above the level of the major duodenal papilla is supplied by the artery of the foregut, that is a celiac trunk, and the part below the major duodenal papilla supplied by the artery of the midgut, that is supplied by the superior mesenteric artery. So this is all about the duodenum.
If you like our video, click on the like button and share with your friends. To get the regular updates on anatomy video by Viva Voice of Anatomy, subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon.